Welcome, RPA champions. I am the RPA champion, and this morning I woke up and I wanted to extract all of the URLs and all of the information from all of the groups that I belong to in LinkedIn. However, there was a problem. The page that I wanted to extract the information from was loading automatically as I would scroll down. So I needed a solution.
Solution is automation.
Exactly, we're going to be using Microsoft Power Automate to give us a hand with this automation. So we're going to create a new process. We're going to create a new process from scratch. We're going to call this process with a meaningful name so that we don't lose it amongst all of the other processes we have. Extract all data from loading a table. That's what it's going to be called. And we're going to start with a blank canvas, meaning that there is going to be nothing inside of your process. We're going to see every step how to do this. So in this video, we're going to see how to open a LinkedIn page in this example, load a table dynamically, and extract the URLs from that table. So let's go to the LinkedIn groups. Let's maximize the link using the option to launch Google Chrome. And let's add also the functionality to run some JavaScript. So let's look for the JavaScript option, so run JavaScript, and let's add the JavaScript. This is going to allow Microsoft Power Automate to execute some JavaScript when the Google Chrome page is open. Let's test the process and see if this is working. So the page is opening and it doesn't seem that there has been anything executed, but that is because we didn't add any JavaScript to our process so far. So let's go back and let's add some JavaScript that is going to scroll all the way down to the bottom of this page, and then we're going to extract all of the URLs from this page as well. So let's go back to Power Automate and extract the URL. So that we don't have to do it, we're going to have Microsoft Power Automate do it for us. Back in Microsoft Power Automate, we have added the functionality to run some JavaScript inside of our process. So let's add some JavaScript. This is the default function that is created by Microsoft Power Automate when you add this capability. So don't remove the function, just maybe remove the comments if you want and put your code in here. I have found some code online that allows me to scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page. So I'm just going to paste this code that I went through, and it looks pretty simple. It's just a function that does another method and a call to scrolling down on the document body. So more or less, I think this should work. I've checked out that this 50 is the interval with which this happens. So this 50 is going to be 50 milliseconds, or it's going to be a really fast interval. So we should scroll down immediately, immediately, immediately. So as we can see, the page is going down immediately. It went all the way to the bottom of the page. Now I have loaded all of the results already on the page. So by scrolling all the way down, I have loaded all of the results. Now I can extract all of the results with Microsoft Power Automate. By extracting all of the results, I will be able to put all of these results in an Excel sheet. So the easiest way to do this is either by dragging and dropping an action, or just by hitting the record button and then extracting, or clicking the record and then highlighting what we want to extract, since this is not a table but a list, and selecting the different things that we want to extract. So in this example, I will extract the URL is the main thing, but just to show you that we can extract also different things. We can extract the image URL, we can extract the number of members that this group have. So we can extract all of this information and put it inside of an Excel sheet from which we can do further automations. So let's save this process. And what we have generated is obviously what has been created by Microsoft Power Automate. So we're going to have to remove some things that we don't need, like the comments and also the navigate to the page. What we are left is with this function. We're going to change it to Excel spreadsheet, extract data from web page. And this is pretty much all of our process. We should add a wait of 4 seconds to wait to load all of the elements. And our process should work. As so far, it has gone all the way down to the bottom of the page. Now it should save all the results in an Excel sheet. And as we can see, all of the results have been saved in an Excel sheet. And we have successfully extracted some 50 URLs from LinkedIn that of all of the groups that we belong to. This is just another example of how automation can be used to save hours, minutes, but save you time by doing repetitive things that you otherwise you would have to do manually. Keep in mind also that there is no website, no captcha, nothing that is safe from automation, and processes can be done in different ways to achieve the same goal. Keep in mind also that the idea is to have the simplest process with the smallest amount of steps inside of the process. This for a couple of reasons. So that your process can be efficient, you don't have to debug it a lot, and that you can build it quickly. Thank you so much for watching, RPA Champions. In the next video, we are gonna see how we can send or upload posts to different LinkedIn groups. Now that we have extracted them all to an Excel sheet, we are gonna be creating a really great process in the next video. So stick around and I will see you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. You are the best.